say I'm trouble. They say I'm bad. They say I'm evil. And that makes me glad.
A dirty no good, down to the bone. Your worst nightmare can't take me home.
So I got some mischief in my blood. Can you blame me? I never got no love.
They think I'm callous, a low-life hood. I feel so useless,
misunderstood.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the baddest of them all? Welcome to my wicked world, wicked world.
I'm rotten to the core, core, rotten to the core. I'm rotten to the core, core, who can ask for more? I'm nothing like the kid next, like the kid next door. I'm rotten to the, I'm rotten to the, I'm rotten to the core.
Are you late again?
Put the beautiful
shapes away. I've had enough of how late you come. Gabby, I'm looking at you. Put your feet away. It's so weird. Why can't you sit normally?
It's my
fit. Nicole, what is your excuse?
It took me forever to walk from the
common
room.
Other Nicole, what's your excuse?
I had to get chicken balls, yeah.
I'm sick of the chicken ball.
I'm sick of the chicken ball.
I'm sick of the chicken balls.
Just tell me what really happened.
Well, it all started this morning.
Okay, everyone, let's get off of period number one now. Let's go, it's time to get to class. Perhaps surprise your teachers, perhaps be there early for a change.
And on today's episode of The Commons, we will be looking at the season's highlights.
Hello, Megan Coyle. Hello, Charlotte Lindsay.
How are you going today?
I was better.
So, while I'm here, I might as well ask you a few questions for the Year 12 video.
Go for it.
So, who on a night out would you purposefully avoid?
Pega.
Pega?
Mm.
And who is your favourite year level?
But you're eight.
Who do you think is most likely to become famous?
Oh, that's probably the easiest question of all. There is someone in my class, I've sat through a 15-minute French horn solo, but also they actually once played for the MSO and had a solo, so.
What do you think in our year level is most likely to become a dictator?
It's so hard to answer because there's so many year 12s who are 100% capable of subverting authority and, you know, mobilizing people to overthrow it. Is it Alex? Mayor, I think, would be our natural politician.
Thank you.
That would be able to mask the subversive tendencies until it was too late.
Mm.
And Wendy, definitely, just in terms of sheer sociopathy.
The survivor zombie apocalypse. Who's the first to go?
First to go.
First to go.
Tash Rupar.
Okay, the thing about us Australians, everyone's a coffee critic. Yeah, we're a pretty laid-back bunch. But you give us a lacklustre latte, we'll turn it into a down-the-sink cappuccino. Here, our tradies construct coffee orders so complex they require blueprints. We're just regular people with irregularly high coffee standards. That's why at McCafe, our smooth, rich new blend, roasted in Melbourne, is nothing short of... It's not just coffee fit for a king or queen. Oh no, it's coffee fit for an Aussie.
What is one word you think really describes our Year 12 cohort really well?
I think the word would be resourceful, because you can always like be able to face the challenges and can think of how to solve the challenges. If you ask me, have another word, I think it would be resilience.
Memorable.
Can I go for better, banter, than Trinity? Enthusiastic. Dynamic, and very obsessed with 1D.
Caring. Vivacious.
different.
Is passionate. Because no matter what it is, if you're passionate about each other, your goals, your academic progress, you just live everything so enthusiastically, and I really appreciate that about all of you.
Beautiful.
Aww, that's so sweet.
Erotic.
That's quick. Just divine, really.
Energetic, bubbly, and it's been a ball to get to at least know you for the year I've been here.
You had a bit of a main character moment.
Yeah.
How does it feel?
Yes. Golden buzzer.
Golden buzzer moment. What, your first time singing in front of everyone? How did that feel?
It was probably, you know, one of my deepest fears to sing in front of a large audience. I've never done it outside of my home. So, yeah, it was pretty scary, but I felt really supported by the Year 12 cohort. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was just a great time. Yeah.
Let's roll that clip.
Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain, we all have sorrow.
One piece of advice for your Year 12s for schoolies.
I thought you might ask me that, so I came prepared.
Oh.
The most important thing is to know where you are going. Okay, so please, you know, there's so many places to go, but if you're going to go somewhere, please make sure that you can tell someone where it is. Okay, that's really important.
Don't go. No, stay with your friends.
Good.
And especially CGGS girls, because they are very responsible, and we know that you will always make informed choices.
Yeah.
Do that and enjoy yourselves, because you deserve it. You've worked really, really hard.
Did you go on schoolies?
I did go on schoolies, but I was a nerd, and we went to our friend's beach house and we spoke to no one. We played board games the entire time. So that's my advice.
I was a nerd.
Yeah, it was.
What do you mean?
Still am. Okay, I get the correction. My advice is do that. Don't talk to other people. Just hang out with your friends and have a good time.
Okay.
Are you in contact with any of these friends after recent events?
No. Good luck to you guys.
I think it's really important to pace yourself, much like Year 12. Don't study too hard early, like you would in Year 12, so don't go too hard early. And it's important to stay hydrated. There's various ways you can do that, such as 1 before 11 or 11 after 1. And yeah, as I said, it's all about pacing yourself.
Stay safe, make responsible decisions, have fun, obviously, but look out for one another. And make sure that you are making some decisions that are positive.
Hydration. Hydration. Okay, so have your emotional support water bottles that I know everyone has. I can see it around the room. And make sure you just stay super hydrated to keep your clear skin, but also to make sure that you're getting all those toxins out of your body. Toxins that have nothing to do with anything, I'm sure, but just keeping yourself hydrated is very important.
Stay safe.
Whoever you go away with, everyone know how to cook at least one meal.
How does this interview compare to our Channel 10?
I'll be more fond of this one. I'll say that. The other one, yeah, didn't go down as well.
And this year, despite the weather, we've covered ourselves in fur and gone as Ewoks.
That makes no sense at all.
What's your favourite school hymn?
Look, there's always Shine Jesus Shine, which we all love. But I adore the blessing song.
Absolutely, I have to agree. The blessing song and probably the power of your love.
Yes.
So, Mrs. Poyser, can you finish the lyric? Brought by brave hands.
Long past the dead. Oh, God!
God, thou the school, neath thine no shadowing.
Yeah.
That was amazing!
The next question.
Yeah.
Who is your favourite student?
Be honest.
I don't have
and
any.
And why is it me?
No! I actually don't have any favourites. You all have a special place in my heart, so no favourites over here.
I don't have favourites, but it's Abby Howard. No, I like lots of students a lot.
Which year level do you
like? What's your most favourite thing about our year level?
The energy that you bring. You guys are amazing. Oh, I love coming into class. We have such a good time. And learning together is an amazing experience.
It's when I walk through your locker area,
people actually get eye contact with me and smile and say hello.
Oh, actually, yeah.
I love that.
What is your favourite thing about our
youth? That you will engage with whatever wacky exercise I bring up, you trust me. That's what I like.
You're always really happy.
Your energy and enthusiasm.
Now, what's your least favourite thing about our youth?
Now that's hard.
Definitely the idea that turning up to class on time is optional.
You're always really tired.
Your poor punctuality. Apparently someone said Mrs. Litchfield is going to crucify us.
Got to think about that. Okay. When we did enzyme substrate and you piffed the ball at my phone when I was trying to illustrate the point.
Right.
And where are you? I think it was Teresa.
It was Teresa. Yeah. Yes. Okay.
I remember Teresa.
How do you feel about us leaving?
I've got really mixed emotions because so many of you were in junior school when I arrived, because I've been here as long as Mrs. Boyser, and so I sort of remember you really clearly in junior school, and it seems, yeah, it's I'm very melancholy about you going.
Yeah, I'd have to agree too. When we took that photo the other day out in the labyrinth, there were so many students that were from all the way from junior school. So I'd actually say sad.
What is your advice for the year 12s for the future? For the future? My advice is that you recognise it's your future, so you have to own it.
I would probably say don't let other people's opinions be the measure of your success.
Enjoy whatever comes your way. If it's not what you planned, enjoy the scenic route.
You can always change, so just try everything and you'll find the thing that you need.
I hope you can get out of your comfort zone and to do some more new things, do some more activities. Also, I hope you can be yourself, be active on the campus and enjoy your life.
Follow your passions if you can. As that will create curiosity.
Never settle for less, girls. You deserve the best.
I think the piece of advice is don't ever underestimate yourselves and don't think that you have to know everything that you're going to do before you do it. You know, there is room for some faith. You know who you are generally as people. So just don't ever underestimate what you can do.
Yeah, I think likewise. Be true to yourselves. Always be true to yourselves. You've got great values and morals, each and every one of you, so you know right from wrong, and if you shoot for the stars, you can always reach the moon.
Jeff, come on, where's my mic? Hey, you two! My friend is in the office. Jenny, what are you doing? Rob, where's my script? Breaking news. Private schoolgirls' bags and computers are getting broken and destroyed. Why? Well, that's a question only answerable by Mr. Burnell. Andrew Burnell. Now, these exploits have actually been caught on camera, and this footage is exclusive and live. All right, so stay tuned. Because we don't know what this man is going to do next.
How many subjects have you tried or done through your VCE journey?
So it's been a bit of a process. I started with, well, at the start, I was going to do Englang. Then I ended up in English. So at the end of the day, I've got... Oh yeah, I forgot art. I did do art for like 2 days.
What's the worst thing you got in trouble for?
Buying fish and chips with Alice.
I don't get caught.
Ooh. Second earring here, which may have caused some Burnell outrage in the common room. That was not really lovely.
I'm getting caught skipping assembly with Charlotte and Pega and getting taken down to Mrs. Poyser's office and having to explain my way out of it.
Probably year 8 when we had a really formal assembly, and after Mr. Maycock called me over and he was like, he gave me a demerit point for having unnatural hair colour, and he said that my hair was green but it was just the chlorine from so much swimming and diving, and he didn't believe me.
Probably talking in class. Yeah.
That's the worst thing ever.
Okay. Yep.
All right.
Goody, Olivia.
How much money have you two spent on chicken balls this year?
Do you want to say?
More than 100?
Definitely.
What's one word to describe our year level?
Chaotic.
Vivacious.
That's a big word, Tash.
Effervescent.
Whoa. Damn.
Really flexing there.
Yes.
I actually do study English language.
Hey, Charlotte, is that a sandwich?
Andrew, that's a really great question. It is. It's from Fig Tree. Probably rate it 3 out of 5. You know, the bread's a bit like sandwich connoisseur account. Like, guys, we just look at this. It's... has to be top tier, okay? Has to be top tier. Best one yet, guys. Oh, no, actually, Whiplash, pretty good. But this one...
Who's that guy?
Oh, no,
everybody, finish the lyric. Shy, Jesus, shy.
Thank you so much.
May the Lord bless you today. And maybe da 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 da.
Yeah!
Yeah.
Do you want this?
What's that? Okay.
Thanks.
Shine on me.
Shine on me.
Shine, Jesus, shine. Fill this land with the Father's glory.
Brought by brave hands, the past has laid.
Long dead,
long
most.
Dead, long dead.
What is your favourite subject? Probably geography. Really? No.
What advice do you have for younger year levels?
My advice is don't post TikToks right before formal because your date will uninvite himself.
Who's Tutu?
Tutu is the nickname of the guy I took to formal after Mr. Burnell named him after like my numerous date swaps.
Did somebody say just ding dong? Want my curry in a hurry, exercise on the low. And I want acai, yeah, 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 when I'm ordering delivery. A little sushi while I watch a movie, papaya salad while I sing a ballad. Need some ice cream, make it a swirl, gotta treat this California girl.
Hey guys! Can I ask you a question for the Year 12 video?
Yeah.
Okay, so who's most likely to be our biggest advocate?
Mr. Burnell.
What's something you'll miss?
I'm probably going to miss just like knowing everyone at school.
I probably think I'll miss our spares a lot because we spent them really well and very productively. Yeah.
So productive that we made a cake in the air fryer. Yeah.
Yeah. How was the cake?
Oh, it was a...
We received lots of good reviews. In fact, yeah. Mr. Bernal had a nice taste test. He didn't go back for seconds, but he said it was quite good.
That's good!
Honestly, nothing.
Whoa, bro! I'm gonna say Jane, but I guess
I'm gonna miss Charlotte.
Gonna say you now.
She's the best person.
Yeah, Jane is the best person.
There's no one else of
you
this.
Can't say that.
I think mostly like the music department as a whole, and even though I dread morning rehearsals, I think actually like I'll probably cherish that the most, and I'll miss it the most. Yeah.
I'm gonna miss every single period five.
Okay, so I'm going to miss physics with Mr. Paz the most.
Yeah.
Honestly, physics is my highlight. If Mr. Paz is watching this, shout out to physics classes with you. And also, he would get us like a hot drink or something from the cafe after our sacks.
I'm not going to miss the stairs.
I will not miss the early mornings or like staying after school because like I enjoy my sleep and I like taking naps in the afternoon, you know?
We will both not miss driving 45 minutes to school. It sucks. Don't do that.
Yeah, gotta love living in areas where people don't even know what it's called.
Yeah, does any of you guys know Bayswater?
Me?
Yes, thank you! I actually know Bayswater! Nice, so just for all of you who don't know, it's not a bay and there's no water.
Yeah. I actually picked up my Bible from Bayswater
when
it was on the book list.
You know what? I'll definitely miss seeing my friends every day and just knowing going to school. And then seeing everyone and like the school community, I feel like everyone's so close over the past 6 years. I feel like I'm really gonna miss that.
So what's your favorite memory from CGGS?
Really broad.
Well, back in year nine, we were having a little music project. It was with these girls here and we had decided to meet in the music department, right? I was like, I have to go to the bathroom. So then I went to the bathroom in the Robinson Hall toilets, the small ones with the two cubicles. Yeah, do you know them? So, you know, I do my business. That was fun. Wash my hands. And then all of a sudden, I hear Sasha's voice through the door. And I was like, oh my God, they're coming in and they're going to scare me. And I was like, oh my God, I should scare them. And so then, you know, I still got wet hands because I couldn't turn on the dryer because otherwise that would like alert their presence. And then all of a sudden, the door is opening and I'm in position and I'm going, yeah! Rah! And as the door is opening, I realize I'm looking at a floral shirt. Sasha and Loz aren't wearing floral. And then I'm like, well, it's too late now. And I'm halfway through my scream. And Kathy Poyser is there. And then we had a little bit of an awkward silence, and I was like, I thought you were my friends! And she was like, I can be your friend! And I was like, okay! And then she was in the doorway still, and I shuffled by her and said, okay, bye! And that was that.
And then later that day,
I was signing out to go to an appointment, and the reception was quite full. And then all of a sudden, someone, like, rah! Behind me, and I was like, and it was Kathy Poyser, and she announced to the whole everyone in the reception that, what I'd done. So that was pretty memorable.
So in year seven, I started playing Fluffy Golf on my iPad. And then, what was it? Dr. Reed wasn't here. And so Mr. Ho grabbed my iPad, and I thought I was going to get in trouble. And then he just started playing Fluffy Golf with the rest of our class, and then we just spent that entire period just playing Fluffy Golf.
Probably the morning after our formal, which was a Friday morning, great time, that English period, if you're there, you'll know.
What's your favourite thing about the year level?
My favourite thing about the year level is how everyone's always there for one another.
Bella!
Hi, come sit.
Oh, thanks.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Good, how are you?
Pretty good.
What was your favourite memory at CGGS?
That's a great question. Well, not to be cheesy or anything, but when I met these beautiful girls. I love them with my whole heart. I know, classic Bella being corny. But yeah, no, I think this is one of my top memories, is finding my girls, you know, finding my little girl gang.
Have you ever had the feeling you're drawn to someone? Yeah, and it isn't anything they could have said or done. And every day I see you on your own, and I can't believe it, you're alone. But I overheard your girls, and this is what they said.
She'd take the world off my shoulders if it was ever hard to move. She'd turn the rain to a rainbow when I was living in the blue. Why then, if she's so perfect,
do I still wish that it was you?
Perfect don't mean that it's working. What can I do when you're out of sight? In my mind, 'cause sometimes I look in her eyes, and that's where I find a glimpse of us, hoping I'll find a glimpse.